Now let us look into some of the questions related with the needle vibrators that are used in vibrating the concrete. Okay. What are the different sizes of needles in an immersion vibrator? These immersion vibrators are available in the size range of 25 mm to 90 mm. Where, what is this 25 mm? This is the diameter of this needle. Okay. The most preferred dimensions that fall in this range are 25 mm, 35 mm, 40 mm, 60 mm, 75 mm and 90 mm. For the general purpose, we use 40 mm. 40 mm is used for all types of residential buildings. Okay. 35, 40 and 60. These are the preferred size, most preferred size. What should be the vibration timing and specification to run the immersion needle? When we run the immersion needle at a particular concrete point, when we poke the needles, the vibration should not be more than 15 seconds at that particular position. Okay. If you vibrate more than 15 seconds, the concrete will get segregated. Okay. So, the preferred timing is between 5 seconds to 10 seconds. Okay. Once you immerse the needle, it should be vibrated for 5 seconds, minimum 5 seconds and not more than 10 seconds. And in any case, you should not vibrate the concrete for more than 15 seconds. Okay. The needle covers the concrete area at a radial distance of 10D to 13D from its vibration point. That means where D is the diameter of the needle. Okay. These are the diameters 25 mm, 35 mm, 40 mm. So when you use 40 mm needle, suppose the distance between the area covered by the vibration is 10D, means 10 into 40, that is equal to how much? 400 mm. So you can say 40 mm needle will cover the concrete area of 400 mm, or we can say the effective area is 400 mm for 40 mm needle. Okay. Third question. What are the ideal needle sizes for different concrete structures? Okay, I have bifurcated the ideal needle sizes. For the slab, for the chajja, etc., it should be between 25 mm to 40 mm. For the columns, beams and single mesh footings, in all such structures, it should be between 40 mm to 60 mm. Okay, the ideal size will be 40. For the precast girders, panels, double mesh heavy footings, means all types of heavier structural members, the needle size should be between 60 mm to 90 mm. Okay. Now, what are the precautions to be taken on the construction site regarding needle vibrators? The vibration period of the needle at the immersion point in any case should not exceed 15 seconds. That's what I explained earlier. Okay. This is the precaution number one. We have to select the needles of specific size. Means when you are vibrating a slab, you should not use a needle of 60 mm. Okay. It will segregate the concrete. So specific size. For the slab, you should use 40 mm. 25 to 40 mm. Okay. According to the type of RCC structure. Vibrating needles should not touch the formwork. Okay, formwork, what happens if you touch the vibrator needles, it will open up at the joints, and to prevent the formation of gaps or opening in the formwork, you should not touch the needles to the formwork. Okay. Standby needle and vibrator machine is a must on a construction site to carry the ongoing concrete work smoothly. Suppose the vibrator machine that you are using fails, so you cannot stop the concrete work. Okay, you cannot stop the work. So it is better to keep a standby needle and vibrator. Okay, to carry the concrete work smoothly. Thank you for watching. Bye bye friends.